One question I get a lot as a PCOS dietitian is, how do I increase my progesterone levels? I have PCOS and I've been told I have low progesterone. What do I do? In this video, we're going to talk about the three reasons you've probably been told you have low progesterone and three things you can do about it. Make sure you stick around to the very end because I have a special surprise for you that you're not going to want to miss. In our video last week, we talked about ovulation, and because we were talking about ovulation, we had to talk about progesterone. Progesterone is that mother hen hormone. It increases your core body temperature, just like a hen sitting on her eggs. It holds in that uterine lining, creating that supportive environment for implantation. And as long as you have high progesterone levels, you can sustain pregnancy. It's actually pretty common for somebody with PCOS to be told that they have low progesterone levels. So let's talk about why. The first reason you may have been told in PCOS that you have low progesterone is that you may not be ovulating at all. You only make progesterone after you ovulate. So in a normal 28-ish day cycle, which most of us with PCOS don't have, you would ovulate around day 14. So day 14, your body would start making progesterone, and half of your cycle, you'd be making progesterone. If you're not ovulating, I'm sorry to be the bearer of bad news, you're not making progesterone. Also, side note, if you're on a hormonal birth control, you're also not making progesterone. Birth control is not regulating hormones like some doctors may have said to you. It's actually giving you synthetic hormone-like endocrine disruptors, basically stopping your body from making its own hormones. So if you're not having a period at all, if you're on hormonal birth control, or if you're not ovulating, you're not making progesterone. The second reason you may have been told that you have low progesterone is that you ovulate infrequently. So most of us don't have that perfect 28-30-day cycle. Maybe you have three or four cycles a year. If you have three or four cycles a year, you may have ovulated three or four times. You only make progesterone for about 14 days after you ovulate. So if you only ovulate three or four times, over a cumulative year, you don't make very much progesterone. This is the second reason you may have been told that you have low progesterone. This is probably like the least common reason your doctor may have said it to you, because doctors typically test for progesterone on day 21 of your cycle. If you have longer cycles, you may not even ovulate by day 21. So you're never going to show high progesterone levels at that time point. Now, the third reason you may have been told that you have low progesterone is that you may actually ovulate and make low progesterone levels. There's a certain amount of progesterone that is adequate both for implantation to occur and to lower the risk of miscarriage. And if you're not making high enough levels of progesterone, then those could be outcomes. So if you're in this case where you make progesterone, you do ovulate, you're just not making it enough or long enough after you ovulate, you can have issues with conception. So if you fall into this group where you're not making enough of it, or you're not making it for a long enough period of time after you ovulate for implantation to occur, you could have problems with not conceiving or having really early miscarriage. We want to alleviate those things with you. We want to help you ovulate more often. We want to help you ovulate at all. So no matter what category you fall into, if you've been told you have low progesterone, I want you to listen to these tips. The first set of tips fall in the category of nutrition. Ding, 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 I'm a dietitian. Of course, we're going to talk about nutrition. These tips are things that seem really simple, but they may not be all that easy to implement. Things like eating 30 grams of protein at every meal, increasing your fiber, or even front-loading your calories earlier in the day. That's right, I'm actually advocating the opposite of intermittent fasting. I want you to eat a big breakfast. Grandma was not wrong when she told you it was the most important meal of the day. Those who eat breakfast tend to ovulate. And so with PCOS, I'm going to ask you to eat a high amount of protein and make sure that you're eating breakfast. Fruits and vegetables are also a really big piece of the puzzle, eating nuts and seeds. There are a lot of ways to incorporate nutrition principles to help you ovulate with PCOS, but many of them kind of go around the idea of improving blood sugar levels and improving insulin resistance. So we're going to focus on that as a core tenet of improving progesterone levels. Now, those things will help you if you're not ovulating at all. It will actually also help you if you are ovulating, but not enough, or you're not making high enough progesterone when you do ovulate. So nutrition is a huge category. Lifestyle factors that go along with it, like getting a good night of rest so that you have enough energy to get up in the morning and make a big healthy breakfast, those are great too. But in this video, we're going to concentrate on nutrition. And the second category we're going to talk about is supplementation. Supplements are a really great way to try to increase progesterone levels, both with improving egg quality and with actually boosting the way your brain talks to your ovaries to make progesterone. So the two different supplements we're going to talk about, one's called myo-inositol. Myo-inositol is one of those big hitters in PCOS supplements. It helps with a lot of things. It lowers testosterone, which can actually help improve egg quality. It helps stimulate ovulation, which can help increase low progesterone levels. And it can help boost progesterone levels when you are ovulating. So it kind of helps in a multifaceted way. One of the ways that it helps is by improving insulin levels. So as insulin levels come down, progesterone levels work inversely of that. That means opposite, they go up. Myo-inositol is a really great fit for somebody who's trying to ovulate and improve progesterone levels. The second one that I think about when I think about supplements is a supplement called Vitex. You can also see this on nutrition labels as Chase Tree Berry. Vitex is a really important supplement in the women's health world, and it's a great way to help regulate cycles. It also is the only supplement that is widely known to improve progesterone levels specifically. So I love using this with clients that aren't ovulating or are ovulating and have low progesterone levels. All right. You ready for the third group? The third group is actually medicine. I love medicine for low progesterone levels because it can help in a number of ways. One of the ways that it can help is by taking progesterone itself. Now, this is a bioidentical progesterone that we want to take. We don't want to take a progestin, which is a synthetic hormone-like structure. We want to actually take progesterone. Now, you can take this in an oral capsule, or you can actually use it as a suppository. Suppositories are something that you insert inside of you, and this type of suppository is specifically a vaginal suppository. So you would insert it kind of similar to a tampon. When I'm recommending progesterone for hormonal health or to help improve fertility rates or to lower miscarriage risks, I'm always going to advocate first for suppository progesterone. Just comes with less side effects and, in my opinion, seems to be more effective. But taking oral progesterone is better than not taking any progesterone at all. Now, you need to hear this. Once you start taking progesterone, your body is not going to try to ovulate. So you only want to take progesterone after you know that you have ovulated. There is such a thing as cyclical progesterone use to try and stimulate cycles. I've seen a lot of naturopaths start doing this. So if you're going to try and take progesterone in that way, I recommend working with a naturopath that can prescribe and help you through the obstacles that may be intertwined with trying to increase your ovulation chances with cyclical progesterone use. Cyclical progesterone use is something that you do to try and mimic your cycle, get it cyclical. You use it and then you stop and then you use it again in a way that's similar to how you would ovulate naturally. This can be helpful. I don't love it for my fertility patients because if you're using progesterone every 14 days, we may be using progesterone and actually stopping you from ovulating on your own. Your body could be improving and needing a chance to ovulate and just needing more time than we're giving it. So taking oral progesterone, using a suppository progesterone, working with a naturopath if you want to try using cyclical progesterone. What I do not recommend is progesterone creams or oils. I have a lot of issues with these, number one, because they're just not potent enough to make much of a change. But also, you could be getting less progesterone than you think or varying amounts of progesterone. And when we're using it to try and help fertility rates, that's not something that we want. We want stability in the amount of progesterone that we're using time and again. All right, so I told you if you stuck around, I would give you a surprise. If you head over to PCOSformularies.com and type in progesterone YouTube, so progesterone, look at how I have it here on the video, and then YouTube, you're going to get 20% off one-time purchase of our antioxidant ovary formula. The antioxidant ovary formula actually has myo-inositol and Vitex in it. It also has two other antioxidant components, CoQ10 and alpha-lipoic acid. These help with egg quality. It's a great supplement if we're trying to get you to ovulate improve egg quality, or increase progesterone levels. So head over to PCOSformularies.com to check that out. Now, if you have more questions about PCOS and you want to learn more about ovulation, check out this video or some of the other videos in our channel, and I can't wait to see you next time.